Good morning, children. This is Venugopal sir for Little Hearts Publications with English Book 3, Lesson 4, The Magic Bird. Before we go into the story, there are some questions under formative assessment. After discussing them, we go into the story. Have you seen birds, children? Yes? What birds have you seen? Generally around you, most of the time you can see crows, C-R-O-W. Sometimes we see sparrows, house sparrow. Sometimes we see, very rarely of course, parrots. Sometimes we see eagles flying very high in the air. But do you know the names of all the birds that you have seen? We are not sure. Maybe or may not be. We are not sure whether we know the names of all the birds that we see. But children, do you know that some of the birds are able to speak? They have the ability to speak by learning how to speak the words from the human beings. Do you know some of the birds can speak? Some of the birds can sing, like a cuckoo bird. And birds like parrot can speak like human beings, imitating the human voice. Cuckoo bird or kokila. I think you might have heard, generally, this cuckoo bird or kokila sings at the beginning of the rainy season. Once the rain starts falling, the first time rains occur in a particular year or any year, the first time rains fall during that year, the cuckoo sings. Never it sings at any other time of the year. There is a speciality of cuckoo bird or kokila. When somebody, particularly women or girls, singing very melodiously, we call them, she is singing like a kokila, she is singing like a nightingale. Nightingale means cuckoo or kokila. That means her voice is as beautiful as that of a cuckoo bird. So, this is a rainy season and you might have heard the cuckoo bird singing early in the mornings. Okay? And finally, we should also know the meaning of a magic bird. Have you come to know about any magic bird or any bird having magical powers? Let us see about such a bird there in this story. This is a story of two different kingdoms, ruled by two different kings. Shangri-La was a kingdom at the foot of the Nilgiri Hills and was ruled by the wise and gentle king Rishiraj. There was love and peace in the kingdom. Shangri-La was the name of a kingdom. Who was ruling that king and where was that kingdom located? At the foot of the Nilgiri Hills. In a Nilgiri Hills are mountains, children. In social studies, you get that word. Nilgiri Hills at the foot means at the bottom of the Nilgiri Hills. This Shangri-La kingdom was located and it was ruled by a very wise and gentle king by the name Rishiraj. He was a very wise and gentle king. There was love and peace in the kingdom. In his kingdom, there was love and peace. There were no quarrels among the people. And there was love everywhere. Everyone believed that all this was because of Kokila, the cuckoo bird. And everybody in the kingdom believed that there was peace and love in the kingdom because of the bird cuckoo or Kokila. There was a bird cuckoo in that particular land. And not only that, she had a magical voice. Really, that bird had a magical voice. Because of that bird only, there was love and peace in the kingdom of Shangri-La. That's what everyone believed in the kingdom. Dongri-La was the kingdom on the other side of the Nilgiri Hills. What is the name of the other kingdom? Dongri-La. That was located on the other side of the Nilgiri Hills. This side, Shangri-La, the other side of the mountains or the hills, it is Dongri-La kingdom. An ill-tempered and selfish king, Jagat Guru, ruled it. Who was ruling Dongrila then? An ill-tempered, very bad-tempered and very selfish king. Selfish means what? The quality of always thinking about oneself. A selfish king, that see, king always thinks about himself and his own comforts. And he was bad-tempered also. So Dongrila was ruled by an ill-tempered and selfish king by name Jagat Guru. The kingdom was full of hatred and misery. There was love and peace in the kingdom of Shangri-La. But here in the kingdom of Dongrila, there was hatred and misery. Hatred means opposite of love. Opposite of love is hatred. Misery is opposite of peace. Everywhere there were people were suffering there in the kingdom of Dongrila. One day, Jagat Guru was passing through Shangri-La and he was greatly impressed on seeing the kingdom. One day it happened that Jagat Guru, the king of Dongrila, happened to pass through the kingdom of Shangri-La. And he was greatly impressed on seeing the kingdom. He was really impressed. He was greatly appreciative of the kingdom there of Shangri-La. Why? There was peace and love everywhere. Whereas in his own kingdom, there was misery and hatred among the people. On reaching his palace, he said to his prime minister, "Go to Shangri-La and find out how the atmosphere there is so peaceful." So, passing through the kingdom of Shangri-La, the king Jagat Guru reached his palace and called his prime minister. "Mr. Prime Minister, go to Shangri-La and find out how the atmosphere there is so peaceful. How the environment, atmosphere in that kingdom is so peaceful. Find out the reason." He asked his prime minister. The prime minister, disguised as a hermit, went to Shangri-La and talked to the people of that kingdom. Disguised means what? To change one's own appearance so as to conceal one's own identity, so that you are not recognized or you cannot be recognized by anybody. Sometimes you change your appearance completely. That in the movies frequently you see, the villains are sometimes heroes also, put on a false beard and a false mustache, wear the goggles, put a turban on their heads to conceal their identity, to hide their identity, so that the others do not recognize them. So in the same way, the prime minister changed his appearance like a hermit. Means he put on a false beard like a sage. Hermit means a sage. A person living in solitude. What's the meaning of a hermit? A sage. A sage is none other than a person who lives in solitude. Solitude means what? Loneliness. So, the Prime Minister of the Kingdom of Dongrila changed his appearance as a hermit so that people do not recognize him, so that he could hide his identity, went to Shangri-La in the disguised form and talked to the people of the kingdom. After 1 week, he stayed there for how long? For 1 week, means 7 days he stayed in the kingdom of Shangri-La. After that, he came back and told the king. "Maharaja, the people of that kingdom are happy because of a bird, Kokila." He came back to the king and told his king, what is the name of the king of Dongrila? Jagat Guru. Yes, very good. "O king, your majesty, the people of the kingdom of Shangri-La are happy and peaceful because of the bird, Kokila." The king said, let us declare a war and capture the bird. Then the king of, because he was a very ill-tempered and very bad man, the king of Dongarilla said, Mr. Prime Minister, let us declare a war. Let us go to a war with Shangri-La and capture that bird. Means capturing means what? Obtaining by force, using the force. So when you obtain something by force or forcibly, that is called what is called capturing. So the king of Dongarilla asked his prime minister to declare a war so that they can capture the bird, that bird Kokila. The prime minister advised the king not to do such a thing, as the Shangri-La army was more powerful and united than theirs. Then the prime minister advised, O king, don't do such a thing, because Shangri-La's army is much more powerful and united than our own army. So we cannot win a war against Shangri-La. So we should not declare war against Shangri-La. Like that, the prime minister advised the king, Jagat Guru. The king asked them, then what to do? What do we do then? You suggest then. The prime minister said, go and ask the king nicely and he will give you the bird, as he is a very kind-hearted man. Then prime minister advised the king, Jagat Guru, O Majesty, you just need not go to a war with Shangri-La. You just go and ask the king there, Rishiraj, the king of Shangri-La, nicely, and he will give you the bird. If you ask him to give the bird, if you ask him to give you the bird, he will give it to you, because he's a very kind-hearted man. So the next day, the king went to meet Rishiraj with lots of gifts. The next day itself, King Jagat Guru of Dongarilla went to the kingdom of Shangri-La with lots of gifts to meet Rishiraj, the king of Shangri-La. Rishiraj welcomed Jagat Guru with open arms. Very warmly he welcomed the king of Dongarilla. Jagat Guru said, I need to ask you for something. Then the king Jagat Guru of Dongarilla said to the king of Shangri-La, Rishiraj, like this, Your Majesty, my dear friend, I want to ask you for something. Rishiraj replied, you can ask for anything, my friend. What is there? You are my friend. You can ask for anything. Mr. Jagat Guru, like that, he replied. Jagat Guru asked for Kokila, and as Rishiraj was bound by his promise, he could not refuse. Then Jagat Guru asked the king of Shangri-La, that is Rishiraj, you, my friend, please give me the bird Kokila. Because Rishiraj already promised that whatever he would ask, he would give. He could not refuse the request of Jagat Guru. So what did he do? Rishiraj gave him Kokila and also asked his five most trusted men to accompany the bird. So finally, Rishiraj gave him the bird Kokila and asked his five most trusted men, means most believed men. Trusted means most believed people. Most believable people, five of them, he asked them to accompany the bird, follow the bird to the kingdom of Dongarilla. They were to look after the safety of the bird. What was the purpose of sending those five people, trustworthy people? They had to look after the safety and welfare of the bird, Kokila, in the kingdom of Dongarilla. Jagat Guru put Kokila in a golden cage and the guards into dungeons. After reaching the kingdom, what did Jagat Guru do? He put Kokila in a golden cage. And he put all the five men who accompanied the bird in dungeons, underground cellars. A strong underground cell for prisoners. Like prisoners, these five people were kept underground in a cell. In a cellar, in a jail. The Prime Minister said, Maharaja, do not do this. Rishiraj will not keep quiet. When the Prime Minister came to know that the five men who accompanied the bird Kokila to their kingdom were put in dungeons, he advised the King Jagat Guru, Om Maharaj, don't do this, because once Rishiraj comes to know what happened to his men, he will not keep quiet. Jagat Guru replied, he will not kill thousands of people for a bird. I know that, my dear Prime Minister. Rishiraj is such a gentle king, such a peace-loving man, that he will not kill thousands of people for just a bird. He is too kind-hearted to do that. He is such a kind, so kind-hearted man that he will never do such a kind of thing of killing thousands of people for a small bird. Kokila never sang, and this made the king very angry. In that kingdom, Kokila never sang. That made the king Jagatguru very angry with the bird. He tried every way he could to make the bird sing. He tried every way, he tried every method at his disposal to make the bird Kokila sing, but he failed to do so. He failed to make the bird sing in his kingdom. Then what happened one day? Jagatguru went to meet Prashant Baba, who lived in a tiny cottage on the Nilgiri Hills. One day what happened? This Jagatguru went to meet Prashant Baba. One hermit was there, one sage was there, living in a tiny cottage, in a small cottage on the Nilgiri Hills. He went there to meet the Baba. Jagatguru told the Baba about his problem. Then he told the Baba about his problem. Sir, we have got a bird there. When the bird was there in that kingdom, there was peace and love there everywhere in the kingdom of Shangri-La. And I requested the king of Shangri-La, Rishiraj, to give the bird to me, and he gave it to me. But the bird is not singing in my kingdom now. He told him about his problem. Baba asked him, do you really think that the bird is magical? Then Baba asked the king, Jagatguru, King, do you really think that the bird is magical? Jagatguru replied, yes, Baba. Jagatguru, yes, Baba, what is there? Yes, it is a magical bird. You are a fool, said the Baba. Then Baba replied, King, you are really a fool. Jagatguru really got angry with this and got up to leave. When he heard these words, because the king Jagatguru was very ill-tempered man, he got angry quickly with the words of the Baba and got up to leave. He got up from the place and he was about to leave. But the Baba ordered him to sit down, and there was so much authority in Baba's voice that Jagatguru sat down. But the Baba immediately ordered him, you sit down there. And there was so much authority in Baba's voice that Jagatguru sat there only without moving. Then Baba told him like this, it is not the bird that makes Rishiraj's kingdom so loving and peaceful. It is the man himself. See, my dear King Jagatguru, it is not the bird that makes Rishiraj's kingdom so loving and peaceful. Don't think that it is because of the bird that there is love and peace in the kingdom of Shangri-La. It is because of the man. Which man? Because of the king himself. It is peaceful. It is love. There is love there in the kingdom. You know the Sanskrit saying, Yatha Raja Tatha Praja. As is the king, so are the subjects. So you know, dear king, there is a saying in Sanskrit. There is a proverb, an adage in Sanskrit. Yatha Raja Tatha Praja. If the king is happy, the subjects are happy. The people in his kingdom are happy. If the king is ill-tempered in a kingdom, his people also become like that, behave like that. So that means, what is the English translation of Yatha Raja Tatha Praja? As is the king, so are the subjects. Whatever the way king behaves, the people in his kingdom also behave in the same way. Jagatguru realized his mistake and went back to his palace. And Jagatguru now realized his mistake. He went back to his palace. He then went to meet Rishiraj and apologized for all that he had done and returned the bird and the five men. After returning to the palace, went to meet Rishiraj and apologized, means expressed sorry. When you apologize means you say sorry for something that you wrong that you have done. So apologize for all that he had done. What had he done? He had put the bird in a golden cage, and he had put all the five men accompanying the bird in dungeons, in jails, under the ground, and returned the bird Kokila to the king of Shangri-La. After 1 year, a hermit came to meet Jagatguru. So 1 year passed after that. What happened? A hermit, a person who lives in solitude, I told you already, he came to meet Jagatguru. For a few minutes, Jagatguru was unable to recognize him, and then he realized that it was Baba. For a few minutes, Jagadguru was not able to recognize that man, that hermit. That hermit was none other than the Baba, Prashant Baba, that he had met a year before in the Nilgiri Hills. He touched the Baba's feet and Baba smiled and said, immediately on recognizing the Baba, Jagadguru touched his feet. And Baba then smiled and said, I am so happy to see that you followed my advice. See, my dear King Jagadguru, I am happy to see that you have followed my advice. For a few moments, I was not sure whether I was in Shangri-La or Dogra-La. When I came over here, for a few moments, for a few seconds, I could not understand. I was not sure, I was not certain whether I was in Shangri-La or Dogra-La. I can hear a thousand kokilas singing here. What's the meaning of thousand kokilas singing here? I am happy. I can hear so many people living in peace. A thousand kokila singing here. I am proud of you, my dear king. Like that, he said to King Jagadguru of Dogra-La. So children, what do you understand from this story? Yatha raja tatha praja. If the king is good, all his subjects or people also will be good. With that, we come to the end of the lesson. In the next class, we'll be discussing the questions and other exercises. Thank you.